Right, so, the unit creator. Its arrival was as expected, nothing but enthusiasm, which is completely justified. It's so enjoyable to go in and create freakish creatures of the night, and Shrek. There are just so many options, both in terms of what you can equip your unit with, and how you can customize every little detail. Landfall really gives you full control, making the products of even a short session something spectacular. On top of that, looking through all of the unique weapons and abilities, seeing how they work and what they add has also been pretty enjoyable. However, this video won't be a comprehensive overview of the unit creator, nor will I be reviewing this feature. At this moment in time, I'm only concerned with how it influences Tabs' core gameplay loop, making the video more or less a successor to Tabs and the importance of its units. To start, we'll have a look at the new weapons added into the unit creator, and get some conclusive evidence on what they add in terms of their functionality. This section of the video directly follows up my Tabs and Units video that I did a couple of weeks ago, where I said that perhaps the weapons going into the unit creator will have a specific purpose in mind. And, well, weapons can be split into three categories: reskin sharp things, weapons with a gimmick, and gun. A large portion of the new weaponry has been taken from Tabs G, which means a lot of firearms. Originally, I thought that guns would break the game, and be definitively the best weapons in the game, but thankfully for the most part I was wrong. Guns add a lot to ranged weaponry in this game, in a way that previous weapons couldn't. The inclusion of guns provide a weapon for every power level, and make it so that new types of ranged units can be created. For example, the Luger. Doesn't hit much damage, doesn't have great range, so you'd be perfectly fine giving it to a peasant type ranged unit. Rifles and machine guns are also pretty good picks for units. They each have differing specs to make them perfect fits for different types of units. For example, shotguns. Shorter range, but higher DPS. Which would be great for a tank unit, and the Kar98K's low rate of fire and decent damage output makes it great for mid-tier unit. The magazine mechanic included in each weapon also helps balance guns out a bit, and for the most part they share the same drawbacks as every other ranged weapon. Looking at the rocket launcher and minigun, you approach OP territory, as they don't really have many weaknesses. But apart from that, guns are pretty good and open up a lot of possibilities for ranged units in this game. The second type of weapon I was able to identify was a reskinned sharp thing. What I mean by this is a melee weapon that doesn't do anything unique. It just deals melee damage. This is the second most numerous category of new weapons. There are quite a few legitimately cool looking weapons, but there isn't really a lot to say. None of these weapons do anything that hasn't already been done, so as a result, they don't affect strategy. Alright, so the last category of weapons I was able to notice is weapons with a unique gimmick, and they are the least numerous category of weapon. Their impact varies on a case-by-case basis, but on the whole, they do add variety to the new types of units you can create, which is ultimately what I'm looking for when searching through these things. We'll go through some highlight. The mirror shield. This absorbs projectiles and then spits them back out again, as a sort of less effective version of the parry. Projectiles are incredibly unlikely to hit enemies, and it can only absorb one round of projectiles before the mirror shatters and becomes useless. I could see this unit being useful protecting slow moving units against ranged units that have slow reload. Yeah, the use case is limited, but at least it has one. The fan shield. Alright, need any more proof that the fan bearer is useless? Here you go. The fan shield does everything the fan bearer does and is way more versatile. Moving on. The spiky bow. Sort of the cousin of the firework bow, just without the whole sending units into the stratosphere thing, which could be quite annoying if you happen to have pinned an enemy tank, or it might happen to move units out of the line of sight of siege units, for example. The spiky bow offers similar destructive potential without the irritation of upsetting whatever you've got planned. Other weapons in this category include the lightning crossbow, fireball throw, and
I would pick a spoon.
So overall, the new weapons added affect strategy in a positive way. They create the opportunity to create new types of units with niche use cases that otherwise weren't being exercised by the existing units. As well as this, some weapons, like for example the guns, bring together unit roles and create a single unit for more purposes to allow for more flexibility. For example, the Kar98K. It's accurate, has decent range, and can fire multiple shots before reloading, replacing both the musketeer and archer as an effective long and close range ranged unit. And on top of all of this, the new weapons of course can be integrated with old abilities, breathing new life into those abilities. For example, equipping a unit with a shotgun and a leap ability creates a berserker on steroids. Alright, so that was a general overview of the new weapons added and how they fit into the wider Tabs puzzle. In the future, I may go into specifics of each individual weapon, but for now we're keeping things broad. Alright, on to the next chapter of the Unit Creator Saga. The unit creator's reason for being isn't just to deliver new pieces of weaponry, but also to provide a means to Frankenstein your own creation from the components of the units that predate this feature, allowing you to do something as simple as slightly tweak the way a unit works, if you really wanted to, all the way up to creating the perfect combination of ability and weaponry. But what does this do for strategy? Well, it eliminates one of the core values I outlined in the Tabs and Units video, saying that the way strategy works in Tabs requires the player to recognize when and when not to use each unit, arguing that this makes learning units feel rewarding. Here, making your own units means you don't have to identify what a unit does because you know exactly what it's capable of, because you made it, doing away with the rewarding aspect of learning the ins and outs of each unit. You not only immediately know what your units do, but you can also do away with ever having to touch the original lineup at all. The ability to combine unit roles, or just the ability to create those units for yourself in general, challenges the existence of these starting units, but that's exactly what they've become, starting units. The need to learn the individual units has for sure seen its demise, but the need to learn the concepts of which those units embody is still very much alive and kicking, arguably kicking harder. The original units now act as a sort of training to familiarize you with each different type of unit, their strengths, weaknesses, and use cases. You'll still need to know when to use what type of unit, but instead of being able to associate use cases through appearances, you'll need to learn use cases and unit types as a concept. For example, before, if the enemy possessed a powerful boss unit, you'd know to deploy the blister, as it deals an extreme amount of damage from a distance. However, living in this post-unit creator world, it's now possible just to remember the need for a long-distance, high-powered ranged unit, and instead of reaching for your trusty blister, you look for your units to find the one that matches that description. To conclude this section, old units act as an inspiration and a sort of training to help you get the grips of Tabs, but beyond that, won't be used. We now move on to the potential drawbacks of the unit creator's inclusion. The one I can think of is people just using it to make incredibly powerful units, pricing them cheaply and breaking the game. But that isn't a fundamental issue with the unit creator. This is the sort of thing you risk when allowing such freedom. Aside from that though, I fail to recognize any other issues that may arise from the unit creator's inclusion, remembering context to strategy. If you can think of anything, definitely leave it in the comments. We now reach the final part of the video, the overall impact of the unit creator on Tabs. The unit creator is the final piece of this Tabs puzzle, the last major feature promised before the full release, and they saved the best for last. In some ways, the unit creator feels like Tabs 2.0, and after workshop support is added, it will most certainly feel like that. The weapons add a lot of new ways to approach each level, and just looking at the obvious outcomes like the abundance of ways to fix up old units, and the near endless number of new units you can create adds so much more to Tabs. If you wished, you can create an entire new game's worth of units to beat levels with, if all situations were accounted for. Just looking at Tabs as a whole, it feels a lot grander. The experiences for everyone will be different, and in a way, Tabs has evolved. It may seem hyperbolic to say that, and to be honest, I kind of feel it is, but there isn't any other way for me to describe it. There are so many things to do, and so many more ways you can tackle the game, with an experience you can more or less tailor to yourself. Before we finish, I should probably remind you that this is all in context of a game that looks like this. Thank you so much for sparing the time to watch this. Goodbye. I got the best.